No, I was 9 to 10 years old. I saw my father crying. The men used to say, the father, men don't cry, men don't cry. Then I asked, why you cry? I said, Brazil lost the World Cup. I don't know what to say to him. They say, no, don't worry, don't cry. I'm going to win one World Cup for you.
Pele, who is best known as the former superstar legend from Brazil and widely regarded as the best soccer player of all time, has snagged some pretty luxurious real estate in the East Hamptons and in Brazil. In 2018, it was reported that Pele had sold his home in the Hamptons for $2.8 million. He had previously purchased the residence for $156,000 in 1979. Over the years, Pele expanded the home into a lavish, extensive 3,500 square foot estate. Beach access is another major plus. Pele wasn't exactly making the use of the house at age 77, as he had long since retired in his home nation of Brazil. So essentially, after holding on to the home for almost 40 years, he managed to make $2.7 million profit off of it. Not too shabby. In addition, he owns property in Brazil where he even has a museum dedicated to him. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a house tour you do not want to miss. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, so please do not show up at any private residences because it is not safe for anyone. The retired soccer legend had quite the lucrative career playing professional soccer, garnering a net worth of $100 million. Now, this number may not add up to current athletes' net worth, but keep in mind, Pele is pushing 80 years old. At his peak, he was the highest paid athlete on the planet. Just to put into perspective how good Pele was, consider this. Pele's career began with Santos FC after impressing the coach with his incredible skills at the age of 15 years old. He then signed a contract in 1956 and made his professional debut that year, scoring during his first match. By age 16, he would already be the top scorer in the entire Brazilian league. He was quickly called into action for the Brazilian national team, playing at the 1958 and 62 World Cups, in addition to being a national hero for the Brazilian national football team. After retiring, Pele became a worldwide ambassador for football and a political activist who strove to improve conditions for the poverty-stricken in Brazil. In 1992, he was appointed as a UN ambassador for ecology and the environment, and in 1994, he was made a UNESCO Goodwill Ambassador. While Pele was making bank from professional soccer, he was also active in endorsement deals. In fact, in 2016, Pele sued Samsung Electronics for $30 million, claiming damages for false endorsements and the violation of his right of publicity. The claim arose because of a 2015 Samsung ad that featured a man that looks almost exactly like Pele, and another scene featuring the player's signature bicycle kick. While Pele was making bank, he managed to build quite the real estate portfolio, snagging an East Hamptons beachfront home nearly 40 years ago for $120,000. Now fast forward 40 years later, he sold the property for $2.8 million so that he could return to his home country of Brazil. When you look at the nearly $2.7 million property made on the house, you realize Pele knows how to kill it playing soccer and the real estate game. This is just real estate 101. If you snag a nice dig, hold on to it for as long as you can. Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Marlon Palmer. Today we're bringing you another house tour here for you on Famous Entertainment. I noticed 95% of you guys are watching and not subscribed. Like, you guys need to subscribe if you're watching. We post new videos daily, so please do so. We previously reported on the homes of LeBron James and Drake, so if you'd like to, please check those videos out. If you like these videos, please ring that bell for notifications. Follow me on Instagram at ThatDudeMcFly, and hit us up in the comment section down below and let us know whose house tour to do next. Let's get into the video.
I come to my house. I say, Father, you know, my friends, they say I was selected for the national team. He said, yeah, they have they're going to take 5 young players. You going to be one. I say, Father, but Sweden, I don't speak Sweden. He said, shut up. You don't need to speak Sweden.
Back in 1979, while Pele was living in America, he made a $156,000 purchase on an East Hampton beach house. After a series of expansions over the years, the home featured 2 stories, 3,400 square feet, and boasted 7 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms, and had sold for only $2.8 million after originally listing it for $3.2. Probably the most luxurious feature of the house is its location, as it's located on a landscape acre next to Clearwater Beach and Marina, and access to the beach. When talking about luxurious amenities, this home does not disappoint, as the interior includes extra high ceilings, an open floor plan, and a brand new kitchen to go with play area, office, and even a media room. In addition, the home comes complete with an outdoor pool, outside shower, and garage. Upon entry, guests lucky enough to visit enter through a long gated driveway to an airy beach house that features endless floor-to-ceiling windows that boast terrific water views. Located throughout the home, these oversized windows give the rooms life and an airy and roomy ambiance. A living space features a balcony on the second story, overlooking the room, decked out with lavish furnishings and elegant chandeliers chandelier hanging from the ceiling, one of the kitchens that boasts an island, perfectly centered, and spectacular marina views. The double height living room and open dining room area are perfect for casual entertaining, with those views in every direction. The particular living space features a sliding glass door, which gives access to the terrace, outdoor pool, and beach property. The kitchen features an abundance of custom built-ins, hardwood flooring, stainless appliances, marble countertops, and an additional island perfectly centered in the room. If desired, steps away from the kitchen features access to a large dining room. The dining room is decked out with lavish furnishings, steps away from the oversized table, elegant artwork, and a chandelier soaring from the ceiling. On the main floor, windows and sliding doors open onto a wraparound deck, leading to a waterside pool and outdoor shower. But we'll get to the exterior in a minute. The house features a master suite on each of its two floors, and both have sliding doors opening onto the deck. Each of the master suites feature access to an elegant bathroom decked out with sophisticated tiling, a large soaking tub with, you guess it, more spectacular views, and a large standing shower perfect for relaxation. In addition, the suites feature walk-in closets big enough to pose as a room in the house, custom drawers and furnishings, large flat screen televisions, and a grand balcony overlooking the grounds. A lower level den and office media room adds more space to relax, as it features large cozy furnishings, a flat screen television, perfect for binging live televised sporting events, ping pong table, and a wet bar for those that fancy a cocktail. In addition, the home features a detached garage for all of Pele's whips that boasts ample room for storage. With numerous glass sliding doors, the porch and terrace lead to a massive in-ground pool with access to a glamorous outdoor shower. Steps away from the pool and shower, the property features an abundance of lavish furnishings, beach views, and an outdoor barbecue area. This backyard features the utmost relaxation and tranquility, and we're willing to bet Pele has thrown a few parties here. While Pele's home in East Hamptons is quite renowned, there's not a lot of information on his home back in Brazil. However, the massive estate, which resembles a submarine, features a two-story gated property. The second story features a balcony that overlooks the grounds and a first-story lounging area decked out in lavish furnishings. Aerial shots show that the home features luxe amenities including a circular motor court, ample amounts of private grounds, large pool with waterfall and tennis court. In addition, the home is located on a massive property decked out with rolling lawns and manicured grounds. The home is also located not too far from the Pelé Museum, which cost $22.7 million to build over 6 years. The museum showcases trophies and championships, which dedicate to Pelé for all the achievements and success he had built over his career playing football. Alright, so I think we'll bring this house tour to an end here. We got to take a quick look at Pelé's luxurious mansion that features beachfront property. After seeing that fancy house he snagged, what did you guys think? Was everything you would expect out of the great one? Personally, I'm a huge fan of the in-ground pool and outdoor shower. I don't know why you'd want to leave that spot personally, but out of Pelé's features, which ones were your fave? You guys can go ahead and rate them in the comments down below. Follow me on Instagram at DadDoMcFly so we can chat some more. And let us know whose house tour to do next in the comment section below. See you guys next time. Bye.
I have to treat this ball and the ball very nice because they gave me a lot of luck.
Thank you so much.